going to ask that all of our ladies, and gentlemen, you just have a seat, all of our ladies, if you'll just file right on down. We're going to ask, how many of you fathers are here this morning? You're a father. Let me see your hand. You are a father. Hold it up. All right. I want everybody with their hand raised to stand. Amen. Stand with me. Amen. Come on, don't be shy. Stand with me. All right. I want all of you to do exactly the opposite of what these ladies are doing. I want you to just find your way around through the aisle and make your way right up here into this choir. This morning, gentlemen.
blood drawn from Emmanuel's name, and sinners plunged beneath that blood lose all their guilty stain. Lose all their guilty stain.
John, are here to testify to you that there is nothing more powerful, nothing more efficacious, nothing more cleansing than this fountain we have just sung about to you. There is nothing that can wash away a man's sins, a woman's or a child's sins, nothing but the blood of Jesus. We're here to let you know that we, the Northport Church of God, brethren, are standing here washed clean by the blood that can wash you clean and make you free. We stand in the liberty of Christ by his blood. For there's no other name, no other blood, no other sacrifice that can wash and save and cleanse a man. You're looking at men who have agreed that Jesus is the only way. Would you amen that, brethren? So this morning, whatever you have in your life, Jesus is bigger. Whatever you face in your life, whatever sin you carry, Jesus' blood can wash away that sin. Nothing can but the blood of Jesus.
Thank you.
Blessed be the Lord this morning, who by his powerful blood, by his sacrifice, in a generation where the norm is a fatherless home, in a generation where men have no idea what a family is, children growing up without their parents, no fathers in their homes, no one to show them what a heavenly father is really like, no one to example for them the love and discipline of our heavenly father. In that generation, ladies, you're looking at brethren who have decided to be accountable, who have decided to be parents and fathers, who have decided that the calling of God is greater than any pleasure in the world, and that the love of the family is stronger than the love of freedom and the love of the flesh. In that generation that is dark in our day, you're looking at some men who, by the grace of God, have decided to follow Jesus. And they stand, we stand this morning on nothing, nothing other than that blood that we've been singing about, because it is the power of the blood that has given us the grace to stand the test. It's the power of the blood that has given us the grace to be husbands to you, fathers to you, and brethren to you. So would you worship with us this morning as we give thanks to God now for the grace and the power that is in that blood.